Hi, how you doing? Intramuscular injection sites. You're not a lot of use, you haven't got any muscles. Intramuscular, where do you give them? So when we teach anatomy, we talk about the dorsogluteal injection site because we talk about the anatomy of the sciatic nerve, and it's something we want to miss when we're putting needles into the dorsal gluteal region. But there's another site, the ventrogluteal injection site, which has a lot going for it, but people seem to be less confident with the anatomy here. So I'm not gonna teach you how to do the injection. I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna demonstrate the anatomy in the ventrogluteal injection site, what it all means, what we might find there, the muscles, nerves and blood vessels we might want to worry about. All right. Okay, so the gluteal region. Here's the pelvis. So this bone here is the ilium with the iliac crest. Here's the femur with this great big sticky outy greater trochanter. And here we would find that very characteristic human shape of the buttocks, which are formed by the gluteus maximus muscle. Turns out it's really important to us upright bipedal animals. The gluteus maximus muscle will, well, it helps me do that. It helps me stand up. It's helping me essentially going from a flexed hip to an extended hip. So it's extending the hip joint. It's extending the femur at the hip joint. Big, powerful muscle. We'll come back to this guy later. Let's go get somebody with muscle on. Yeah, that's more useful. So, gluteus maximus. And you can see why it's such a popular intramuscular injection site. It's obviously a very large muscle. It's easy to locate, and you can put a large volume in there. The gluteus maximus muscle runs from that ilium bone we were looking at. We can just about see the crest here. And the lumbar fascia back here and the sacrum. It's a big muscle. It's got lots of attachment sites. And it inserts into the femur and also into the iliotibial tract, the fascia, the connective tissue of the thigh. But we worry about structures like this. Okay, so on this model, this is the sciatic nerve. It's actually about, you know, it's like that big. It's huge. It's not that small. I've never seen one that small on a cadaver. They're like, you know, two fingers breadth. Here's the piriformis muscle, which we'll come back to later. So I think I might do another video on the dorsogluteal injection site later. But, you know, so dorsal means to the back, ventral means to the front, and the ventrogluteal injection site is actually around here. It's lateral, so it's on the lateral body. We don't actually get around to the front, but the point is, this is the gluteal region, from the ancient Greek, I think, referring to buttocks. So if this is the dorsogluteal region, roughly speaking, then around here, this is more ventral. So this region is ventral relative to the dorsal part of the gluteal region. But we are in the gluteal region. Now, as we go ventrally, we see there is some muscle here. Important muscle, but muscles that people aren't as aware of. So if this is gluteus maximus, more laterally here, we see this muscle. Look, we've still got the iliac crest. So the ilium is deep to this muscle. This is gluteus medius. And actually, we have two muscles here, gluteus medius and minimus. Oh, that makes sense. If that's gluteus maximus, the biggest one, then there's going to be a gluteus middle one and a gluteus smallest one, right? So if we take off gluteus maximus, we can see gluteus medius, which is most of this. And I'd need to take this off to be able to see gluteus minimus. But the bone here, the wing of the ilium, is covered by two layers of muscle. So there's a significant amount of muscle here. Look, if we remember the muscle here and go back to the skeleton, see how, can you see that curved shape there? So there's a depression in here. So the bone isn't sticking out here, there's a curved depression. And gluteus medius and minimus are attached to the ilium. They're attached to the bone here. They're covering the bone and they're running to the greater trochanter here. So when they contract, they abduct the lower limb. So then, my gluteus medius and minimus, I can feel some bony bits, but I can't really feel the muscles. But if you abduct your lower limb, that's what gluteus medius and minimus do. They abduct the lower limb away from the body, the midline, at the hip joint. And if you walk on the spot, if you take one foot off the ground, or even you don't even have to walk on the spot, if you just do that, you can feel the muscle there. You can then feel the muscle contracting, shortening and lengthening. That's not just the bones moving there, because, you know, there's a little bit of bone moving, but it's the muscle here. So there's quite a bit of muscle there covering the bone. The ilium here in the ventrogluteal region is covered by two layers of muscle. The ilium is curved in there. So in fact, the muscle here is thicker than you might think. And these are large muscles because they are holding the body. They're keeping the pelvis horizontal when we walk, when we take the other foot off the ground. So there's a significant amount of muscle here. So it's a good site for an intramuscular injection and of some significant volume. So that's a good thing, right? That's one tick. Now, what do we need to worry about? So here's the piriformis muscle, the pear-shaped muscle here. It's a good landmark. We can see this tiny sciatic nerve coming out from inferior to the piriformis muscle. All right, so we don't need to worry about the sciatic nerve in the ventrogluteal region because it's miles away. But what nerves innervate the gluteus medius and minimus muscles then, because surely we'd need to worry about those. Well, we can't see them on this model, but the superior gluteal nerve innervates these two muscles. The superior gluteal nerve starts inside the pelvis. So it's, if I spin you around, you'll... So it's in there, it starts inside the pelvis, it's from the sacral plexus. And to get to the gluteal region, it passes out. So underneath this muscle, we have the greater sciatic foramen. And the superior gluteal nerve appears here with this blood vessel, superior to piriformis. And that then sends branches to these two muscles. So the major nerve, the main nerve, the superior gluteal nerve, is actually quite medial. And then as it innervates these muscles, it gives off smaller branches. The superior gluteal nerve is not at great risk of being damaged by a needle in the ventrogluteal region. Now, what other nerves are nearby? There are a lot of nerves in this region, but, okay, what can we think of? Well, I know that most of them run around the abdominal wall, and most of them are superior to the inguinal ligament. Most of them either pass through the inguinal canal or they pass deep to the inguinal ligament. Well, that's miles away. So the inguinal ligament here, deep to that, is a passageway between the abdominopelvic cavity and the lower limb. So there are a lot of nerves that then take that route. For example, see these nerves here. So these nerves, like the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve, the ilioinguinal nerve, the iliohypogastric nerve, these are all very anterior. They're not near the ventrogluteal region. So we don't have to worry about those. Now I know, what about the superior clunial nerves? So I know those are near here. Where's your, there it is. So the skin overlying the gluteal region receives branches from the superior gluteal nerve. So that's how the skin up here of the superior buttocks gets sensory innervation. So there are superior clunial nerves that will run over the, and as in superficial, to the iliac crest. But they're cutaneous nerves, they're quite spread out, they're a little bit the chance of hitting them and causing major damage is low. If you do hit one, the patient is going to tell you immediately. You know, you poke a sensory nerve, You know about it, because you've done that. You've banged your ulnar nerve, your funny bone, right? And I don't think with the ventrogluteal injection site, a needle hitting a superior clunial nerve is, there's a low chance of it. You'll know about it straight away. I don't think it's a major reported finding, a major reported risk. I can't think of any other nerves. So, most nerves are anterior or down here. So the nerves are away from the ventrogluteal site. Okay, what about blood vessels? Well, happily, we have some sensible naming going on here. The artery you can see here is the superior gluteal artery, like the superior gluteal nerve. Now, the superior gluteal artery is also comes from inside the pelvis. It's a branch of the internal iliac artery, so the main artery of the pelvis. So this artery, supplying blood to these muscles, also passes out of the pelvis posteriorly through the greater sciatic foramen. It appears superior to the piriformis muscle, and look, it's very medial as well. And then it gives off superficial and deep branches. The superficial branch will run superficial to gluteus medius. The deep branch will run deep, and in fact it'll run all the way around to the anterior superior iliac spine. And remember that in terms of with arteries, they start off big, and as they give off branches, the arteries get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. Like a tree, you know, a tree's got a big branch, and then as it gives off little branches, they're all smaller and smaller, right? Same principle, because you're supplying the blood that came through this tube to all those little tubes. So that means that as we go from medial to lateral, as we get to the ventrogluteal region, these arteries have become much smaller branches, which means there are not big arteries at risk of being penetrated by a needle around here. Unlike this region, so dorsally, we do have these arteries around here. So, what arteries do we need to worry about in the ventrogluteal region? Just small branches of the superior gluteal artery. What other arteries are there? Nothing of note down here. Where exactly is the ventrogluteal injection site? I should probably point that out. What bony landmarks do you need to be able to identify the ventrogluteal injection site? Let's get our bony friend back. I said that this is the iliac crest. You can palpate your own iliac crest. Very superficial, we saw it on Wee Man. Very easy to palpate most of the time. And if you follow the iliac crest, so this is the ilium bone, this is the crest of the ilium. If we follow it anteriorly, it will end at this bony prominence, which is the anterior superior iliac spine, which students often abbreviate to the ACIS. So iliac crest and anterior superior iliac spine. And then here's the femur. On the femur, as I said, we've got the ball and socket joint here, but this big lumpy bit that those gluteus medius and minimus muscles were inserting into, this is the greater trochanter of the femur. How would you use these bony landmarks to identify the ventrogluteal injection site? Well, there are a couple of different methods, but this is a left leg, so I'm going to use my right hand, and vice versa if I was going to use the other side. Now, if I put the palm of my hand on the greater trochanter, and I put this finger on the anterior superior iliac spine, and I reach that finger up to the iliac crest, in here is the ventrogluteal injection site. Can you see actually how much depth there is there? Can you see how deep the bone is there? Let's do that on Wee Man. So, same principle then. There's the greater trochanter of the femur there. Here's the iliac crest. So the anterior superior iliac spine is there. So if I put the palm of my hand over the greater trochanter, reach around to the anterior superior iliac spine, reach up to the iliac crest, this would be the ventrogluteal region. So you can see now that there's actually a nice big chunk of muscle, that double layer of muscle that's infilling that scallop of ilium that we saw when the muscle wasn't here. So there's quite a bit of muscle thickness there. So the ventrogluteal injection site, it's in the gluteal region, is referring to the ventral part of it, ventral relative to the dorsal part. There are two muscles on top of each other here, gluteus medius and gluteus minimus. The nerves and blood vessels supplying this region are largest more medially. So in the lateral parts or the ventrogluteal region, those nerves and blood vessels have become smaller branches. So as far as I can see in the literature, this looks like a pretty safe place for ventrogluteal intramuscular injections. The way to find that injection site is done in a number of different ways. I've just demonstrated one way of finding it and the surface anatomy landmarks that might be useful to you there. But hopefully you've got a better three-dimensional feel for the shapes here and what's here and some of that anatomy. Like I say, most of the nerves are more anterior. They're running down to the lower limb over here. Most things are out of the way. But I'm just talking about the anatomy. I don't put needles into people, well, not living people anyway. So I'm just giving you the description of the normal anatomy. If you want to learn how to give a ventrogluteal injection, you should speak to someone who's qualified to do so. I know you guys, most of you are probably on health profession courses, right? You're learning this sort of thing. But I hope that was useful from a visual and knowledge perspective. Who doesn't like talking about the human gluteal region, right? See you next week.